Mark Chapeau is a graduate student from University of Wisconsin who is well acquainted with Kansas wild turkeys. For the past 3 months, he and assistant Tracy Sikonik have spent nearly every daylight hour trapping turkeys at the Cedar Bluff, Webster, and Lovewell Reservoir areas in cooperation with Kansas Wildlife and Parks. Their mission? To learn about mortality factors, including hunting, in adult turkey populations. Primary focus was on catching mature gobblers, though they also collared hens at each area. Trapping wild turkeys involved finding large winter flocks, obtaining permission where necessary, and baiting each area with grain for a time before erecting drop nets. The large nets were designed to drop via a wireless trigger system from long distances. However, mechanical failure sometimes added to the frustration of waiting days at a time for turkeys to cooperate. I spent parts of 2 weeks at two locations hoping to film a drop, but target birds never appeared when I was there. Even so, eventually the researchers trapped and collared more than 40 wild turkeys at each location. Caught turkeys were immediately removed from the drop net and placed in individual boxes. Then each was hooded and fitted with a backpack-style transmitter whose signal could be located from a mile or more away. The lightweight transmitters were secured by an elastic cord encircling the base of each wing, allowing normal flight, movement, and behavior. The entire fitting weighed only a few ounces. A leg band that provides contact information and instructions in case the bird is killed by a hunter was also attached to each bird. Each turkey was immediately released. Now, electronic tracking along with GPS coordinates could continue for a year or more. By recovering the transmitters of dead birds, researchers could possibly learn what caused mortality as well. Data about the movement and longevity of wild turkeys will eventually help better manage wild turkeys in Kansas. Chapeau, who is working on his master's degree in wildlife biology, thanks all who helped with the project, especially Kansas landowners who allowed trapping. Several organizations were instrumental in funding the research project.
But this project is a partnership between the university and the Kansas Wildlife and Parks and the National Wild Turkey Federation. They've been great partners. It's really great that the NWTF is getting involved and assisting with this study so that Kansas can have some good information to help manage their turkey populations.
Hunters who kill a collared turkey are asked to cooperate by following the instructions on the leg band. We'll follow this story up in a month or so to find out what's been learned. I'm Mike Blair for Kansas Wildlife and Parks.